ladies and gentlemen out there at VivaLaRivera.com. This is Samara Riviera, and I always say I have a special guest, but today I have the most specialist guest ever because she's an icon in our community. She's almost a legend, we could say. Miss Viva, wait a minute, Viva Sex or Viva Colon?
Viva Sex.
Viva Sex. This is Viva Sex, people. She's been doing Madonna impersonations in the 90s. She started out doing Madonna impersonations in the 90s. And, you know, you're still doing shows now, right?
Still doing shows from the 80s.
Yeah. Oh, from the 80s. Wow. How was it that you discovered that you were, you know, like a Madonna impersonator?
Well, in the beginning, when I found out who Madonna was, I didn't really want to do Madonna. I just, like, captured who she was, and then I wanted to use her to be me. And then, because at first they didn't have photos of her, like in her first album and stuff, and then later on they started saying that, you know, that I should do her because I look like her, and I never seen a picture of her, what she really looked like. And then I saw her, and I used to have dark hair, and then I used to say, well, so she's blonde, so she's the first person that made me actually go blonde. And then I started trying to look like her, trying to do her makeup, and then I just ended up becoming her.
Yeah, because I remember the early 90s, I came out, and we used to go to your shows because you were like our Madonna. You were like everybody's favorite Madonna. You were Madonna's favorite Madonna, I hear. She came and saw your show, right?
Yeah. Yeah, she came to see my show in La Cage. And then I saw her the first time on the set of Material Girl. And then that's when I was dressed as a boy. And then she's like, I told her, I said, I do you for a living. And she's like, oh, you do? And she goes, you don't look nothing like me. I said, but I do. And then I saw her backstage at the Blonde Ambition Tour. And when she finally saw me, she's like, oh, my God, you do look like me. Now I can fuck myself. So that's when it all started.
Yeah, so if you guys want to look at old videos of Miss Viva Sex doing Madonna back in the day, back in the 90s, right? I'm sure they can find them on YouTube under Viva Sex Madonna.
Yeah, I don't have any, too many. The videos that are on there right now are just friends that tape the show and stuff like this. I have a lot of stuff that I've done, but it's not, you know, I never put them out because it's just like something private. You know, once you put it out there, just like everybody sees it. And I mean, it's just, that's not really who I am. I just like to be more private, but there's someone there.
Okay. And, but do you still do Madonna or not? Tell us what's going on with that.
Well, I started doing Madonna a lot, and I was doing her for a very long time. And then she stopped doing music. So I stopped actually doing Madonna. I do Madonna here and there. Like, actually, today's her birthday, and I'm not doing her. Such a bad Madonna impersonator. But happy birthday. And so I started doing, like, I had stopped getting that, how do you say that, that feel of trying to do somebody wild. And, you know, like, I was always trying to keep up with her looks and stuff. And then so I started doing more Viva and just dancing and doing, like, sexy numbers. And then Lady Gaga came out, so she inspired me to do crazy stuff again. So now I do Lady Gaga, too.
Now, who are some of the artists that you also perform today?
I do Gloria Estefan. I did her for a while. I never wanted to do Gloria Estefan, but they always just say they said that I have her nose, that I should do Barbara Streisand or Gloria Estefan. So I did Gloria Estefan, and by doing her, I got to tour with her for about a year. And so I did her for a while. And then I'll do Fergie, you know. But right now it's like Lady Gaga, Madonna. Since Amy Winehouse died, you know, she's making me good money, so I do her too.
And you were in Gloria Estefan's video, right?
Yeah, the Everlasting Love video. And we went on tour with her for a year after that.
Wow, that's fabulous. Now, you've had a wonderful, interesting life. Will we ever see a memoir or a biography? Would you ever write a book?
I've been approached a couple of times because I've been around since, like, the 80s, and I have a lot of stories, and I have a lot of photos. I love taking photos, so my life is very photo-ish. You know, I have everything's on Facebook right now. That's where Viva Cullen's at. And you can see me doing Madonna, Gloria Estefan and stuff on Facebook and Viva Sex. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But, yeah, I mean, there's a lot.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And you're a party promoter, trans party promoter now. How did that come about? And tell us about your parties.
Well, the party started is because nobody wanted to host the show. So I started hosting the shows, and then they started telling me to promote. So I started promoting, and, you know, in the 80s and 90s and the beginning of the 2000s, it's like everything was amazing, as you know. And then it became a reality show kind of thing, and I'm not into that. To me, I don't watch any reality shows. I don't, you know, to me, I don't like all that stuff because it just spawned a lot of people that, you know, before I used to look at people and say, oh, I want to be like Madonna, or I want to be like Vanity. I want to be like Carmen Electra. I want to be like, you know, like Grace Jones. I want to be like Nina Hagen. And now it's just like people are like, I don't want to be anybody. I'm myself. I'm a star, you know, and I'm like, that's not a star. That's not, you know, how can you create? You know, you can become something and create something, and, you know, but you have that talent behind that. I don't sing. I'm not that talented, so my impersonation is what makes my talent. And to promote something like my girls that come to the shows and stuff, you know, our community is so small as a transsexual community. We don't really actually stick together because it's, in L.A., and it's so spread apart that people don't stick together. They only come and around when things are, if it's convenient for them. Before it was convenient to hang out and have a good time, and now people don't want to have a good time. They want to go out and see some show that has comedy in it or something funny, and, you know, my show's not funny. Mm-hmm. You know, my shows are more like, you know, impersonations and people that can dance and can sing with their voices and stuff. So that's how I became promoting stuff.
Okay. Now, what about the parties at the Palms?
Party at the Palms are every Monday and Friday. We're here. Friday nights is always the best because it's Friday night. Mondays in LA is kind of like slow, so it's like iffy. You know, you come. You know, I've just finished promoting. We're going to have Stacey Q here on the 29th, and they're going to do a special on a movie she sang for, and it's called Return of the Living Dead. And I did a promotion for that, and hopefully it'll turn out really good. I mean, my promotions are good. It's for Monday. It's great.
Yeah. I'm always here on Monday nights, so this is where you'll see me. So it's Monday nights, Friday nights at the Palms. What is the address at the Palms?
857. Wait, I don't even know it.
Oh, my God.
It's on Santa Monica Boulevard across the street from the Ramada, one block past La Cienega. I think it's 8572.
And is this West Hollywood or Hollywood?
West Hollywood.
West Hollywood. Okay, so that's Monday nights and Friday nights. And what happened here, though, because I know this used to be a lesbian bar. We're here downstairs in the dressing room. All the hot, sexy girls are getting dressed or undressed for the show. But what happened? This used to be a lesbian bar, right?
It used to be a lesbian bar. Well, when we first started it, you know, when I started working at Club 7969, it was Peanuts. Mm-hmm. And that was a lesbian bar. And then we started taking over, and then we made it more like trendy. So, like, straight people, gay people, people that wanted to dress up and stuff like this. And our transsexual night was on Mondays. And I used to work there on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And then we started intertwining, you know, the transsexual community and telling them to come in. So it actually started to become more of a gay hangout. And it became very popular in the 80s and 90s. It was like Peanuts, so everybody.
Yeah, I used to go there too back in the day.
Yeah.
So what other projects are you working on now?
Right now it's just like I'm doing promotions. I'm still trying to make shows better than they are. I've seen a lot of shows, and I mean, it's just more of people just coming out and not having too much talent. I would like to go somewhere else and show the world that transsexuals are more than just what they see. That, you know, they have talent and they have things to do, you know, so I'm doing that. I work mostly behind the scenes. I do makeup for stuff and help my friends out when they need it. It's just right now in the way this things are, I don't want to involve myself too much because it's just I enjoy doing my show and I don't want to lose that. And if I branch out and do other things, it's going to make me forget about the girls that come here. So you know, I'm a trooper.
Okay. And you are a Latina, right? ¿De dónde eres?
Soy de aquí. Mi abuela es de León. And my mother is German and Spanish from Spain. And so I'm like a mutt.
So, ¿qué le quieres decir a las personas ya para que vengan a tus parties los lunes y los viernes?
Para todos los latinos que están viendo ahorita tu canal, bienvenidos cuando ustedes quieren. Si quieren hacer show, la puerta está abierta para todos ustedes para venir y repetirse.
Okay, any last words you want to say to your fans out there? I know you have a lot of fans. You've created many fans since you've been doing shows. So I'm a huge fan, I have to say. I honestly have to say I'm a huge fan since the 90s because I used to come out when I first came out in the early 90s, and we were like at every Viva Sex show because she was the best Madonna. She is the best Madonna in, you know, West Hollywood history. That's all I have to say.
I just want everybody to actually, you know, stop thinking about, like, the future, the past. Think of the present. Be happy who you are, you know. Don't be embarrassed to what you think that people expect from you. Ever since I was little, I never changed, and I've always been the way I am. I dress the way I do, and if people don't like it, then they can look the other way. And I just want you to be happy. I want you to have a good time, and please, for God's sake, hopefully those, like, reality shows will end.
Well, hopefully, we'll see. But anyways, thank you so much, and I've been looking forward to interviewing you. Finally, we did it, and I'm glad because I'm a huge fan. Thank you, my love.
Thank you, baby.
Miss Livia, put that dick down. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Patrice. The one that's performing all by herself. The one and only Destiny. Don't forget, in 2 weeks we have the station Q here. We're here every Monday night and every Saturday, so I hope to see you here. Our bartenders are Dania. Other lights are Rail. And we're going to leave you with the music of DJ ABC. Have a good night.